Hi, welcome all. Myself Parshuram Arutli, and I'm the master's student from University of North Dakota. I'm here to give my presentation on potential of weight scale based ballistic cardiography for identifying orthostatic intolerance, a tiltable study. These are my presentation outlines, introduction, methodology, results, conclusion, and references. Introduction: falls during standing is common in elderly people and people with neurological disorders. These people fail to regulate blood pressure during standing, which is called as an orthostatic intolerance. The frequency domain heart rate variability measured using electrocardiogram is used for assessment of sympathetic and parasympathetic activity, as ECG require electrodes to be placed on the body, so this limits the portable application. So we will go for ballistic cardiogram, which measures the ballistic forces of heart. So in this study, we are studying the feasibility of monitoring the autonomic activity using a BCG. We are here measuring whether we can replace ballistocardiogram measured from weight scale to replace the ECG. And this is a methodology how I have recorded, or we have recorded, the data acquisitions. So simultaneous recording of electrocardiogram, blood pressure, photoplethysmogram, and BCG were acquired during 5-minute stand test before and after tilt test up to 60 degree from 10 participants with sampling rate of 2000 Hertz. Now here we have used a tilt table or head up tilt to give the orthostatic stress in order to study the autonomic control or autonomous control. And these are the different instrument or the acquisition tool that we have used. So the first one is weight scale developed by one of my co-author, which is used to acquire ballistocardiogram. And the second one is FINAPRESS for measuring the blood pressure, and this is how I measure the photoplethysmogram. All these devices are connected to the BioPack, and by using the software, and we have recorded this all signals. Now the signal processing part. So in a signal processing, the first task is to detect the peak. So we have detected the peak, that is R peak, by using wavelet transform. And again, we have used this R peak and the peak of the PPG to detect the exact R locations and J locations from the ECG and BCG. So once we detect the R peak, then I find the R to R locations or R to R interval. And once I detect the J peak, then we have find J to J intervals. And then after finding R to R and J to J intervals, we have find the power spectral density of all these in different frequency band, that is in lower frequency, higher frequency bands. So this is what the simultaneous, this example shows the how I have recorded, how I detected the R peak and the J peak, if you see this, and then J to J interval, R to R interval. Again, with the help of this R peak, I have detected this systolic blood pressure, diastolic blood pressure. So all these parameters, I have find this. And these are my results. If you see that, this result shows that this heart rate and this frequency domain heart rate variability So there is no difference between the heart, there is no difference in the heart rate during pre and post tilt for ECG derived heart rate and the BCG derived heart rate. Similarly, there is no difference between this heart rate variability parameters during pre and post tilt between ECG derived and BCG derived parameters. So as I want to show some the correlation analysis. So if you see that there is high correlation is achieved during pre-tilt and post-tilt for BCG-derived heart rate variability and ECG-derived heart rate variability. So the conclusion is the finding of this study highlight the feasibility of monitoring the cardiovascular control via weight scale-based BCG. The developed system can gain utility as a portable and cost-effective system for early detection of falls associated with autonomic dysfunction. So these are my references. Thank you.